Yeah, I'm just trying to get this text out. Before we start this, let's go ahead and go with it. Lighting's good. Packages are intact. Hanley looks good. You know what to do. Go ahead and roll with it. Hey, everybody, once again, just wanted to give you guys a shout out for coming in and joining me on another Floyd's Pickups. I appreciate that. I appreciate you guys taking the time out of your busy day to go ahead and watch this video. Very small channel. Like I said, I don't have very many followers or subscribers, whatever you want to call them. So I'd appreciate you guys if you guys are not subscribed to definitely hit that subscribe button. Definitely hit that like button. And if you guys can, drop a comment down below. Let me know who's in the building. Let me know what you guys think about these products. And I would really appreciate that. And then also, I do have an Instagram, very new to the Instagram game. I just created mine back in December. So I'd appreciate you guys to go on there, Floyd Chavez Jr., and give me a follow on there. I would really appreciate that as well. So thank you so much for coming in and joining your boy for another Floyd's Pickups. Let's go ahead and go into it. But really quick, before we get into that, I do got the Lulu Henley on, wearing some blue denim, in case you guys were wondering. Definitely rock that Lulu pretty often. Very comfortable, very great fit when it comes to clothing wise. But I do have a piece right here that I cannot wait to show you. So let's go ahead and go into that. But like I said, definitely drop a comment. Let me know what you guys think about this. This is the first time I actually seen it in person. I have obviously seen it online, so can't wait to show you. And then let me know what you guys think. And let me know if you think what you guys think about this brand also. I'd appreciate that if you guys own any pieces from this brand. And let me know what you guys think about the brand. I know the brand has did some collaborations when it comes to shoes. So let me know if you have any of those shoes in your collection, or if you just were not rocking with this brand at all. Dirty box, so the box definitely goes on top of these shoe boxes. But once again, Sneaker Factory still under construction. Still gonna, hopefully get some things around the Sneaker Factory just to make sure it's cleaned up. But like I said, if you're seeing it now, this is how the current status is. Shoes piled up. All my shoes are actually in the Sneaker Factory, which is a good thing. So definitely a very cool thing to actually see all the sneakers. So here we go. I picked up this piece a week ago, and it just came in. So here it is right here, and I will show you it. I'll actually undo it so you guys can see it. Also, I will be putting this on one of my lives, or I'm sorry, not one of my lives, but one of my shorts, and show you how I would like to style this. But this is a very, very nice jacket. It's a windbreaker. Unfortunately, in California, it is getting hot. So not sure. I might have to wait on this. But if, as you can tell, go ahead and take a look. It does have that iridescent hit on it. It is a brand, John Elliott. So this one I paid a pretty penny when it comes to this jacket. Even though it's very light, not very thick, I would not wear this like on the East Coast or Midwest if I was when it was snowing, because this is a very, very thin jacket. For the price, you would think it's a lot thicker, but I'm actually just probably paying for the name, but also the very cool color on this jacket. So typically, when it comes to clothing, like tees, jackets, I tend to buy a medium. John Elliott, though, is very oversized, probably at least one size up. So I tend to size down when it comes to John Elliott, when it comes to shirts, jackets, sweatshirts, stuff like that. So this is a small. I'm hoping it fits. It looks like it fit more on the fitted end. I'm not a heavy person, athletic build pretty much. So this should do the trick. I will be definitely putting this on, trying this on to see if it, hopefully it fits good. But I'm gonna put it there for now. But I think it's a really cool piece as far as I love the color. It's very, it has that iridescent hit. I'm a big fan of iridescent. I do have some Fear of God iridescent shorts for like beach wear or for pool wear, or even if you just have to go run an errand, that's typically when I wear them. Very, very cool. As far as I love how iridescent hits when it comes to like the sun, it gives off that purplish greenish look depending on how the sun's hitting. And then also I do have that Keth watch with the iridescent kind of, I want to say, face covering in a way. And then that's a beautiful hit. I should have wore that. Actually, I haven't even wore that at all. So I probably would not wear it because it does have that translucent wristband, and that will probably definitely yellow if the sun hits it. So more than likely, I probably will not give that a wear. But I'm pretty sure I've showed you guys that. I know I probably showed you on one of my shorts that watch. So in case you ever want to see that watch again, definitely go in there and take a look. So let's go ahead and go on to the shoes. This is probably what everybody wants to see. Brand new pair. This is one of the pairs that just came in this week, so I can't wait to show you. I probably more than likely will be doing a what's it called? A sneaker profiles on this shoe. Right now we are currently at the Thanksgiving, I believe. Depending on when I drop this video, I believe I have I'm going into another series after Thanksgiving, and then I'll probably be releasing a series on these along with some other new pickups. So be on the lookout for that. So let's take a look at this one. This is a StockX pickup. Like I said, I never hit on SBs at all for retail, unless maybe by some magical moment I hit them on like the sneakers app, which is very rare. That rarely happens, but unfortunately I had to pull the trigger when it comes to resale on these ones. I really wanted them, especially so they can go with this jacket. That's why I put this combination together. But there you go. Size 10 and a half, in case you guys were wondering. Your boy always buys 10 and a halves. Majority of the pie, I would say maybe 95% of the collection is the size 10 and a half. Since I've been moving, or the when I took stuff out, but mainly when I was bringing stuff back into the factory, I did come across a few 11s. So I do have a few 11s, and that was because I just probably couldn't find it in my size because they're an older shoe. So that's why I had to purchase an 11. But majority of my shoes are 10 and a half. So yeah, in case you saw that purple box, so you know it's a GR. I'm not sure if these hit skate shops as of yet, but these are SB GR. I'll read you the description. So it's Keiko Wow Summit White. Probably butcher that name, but whatever. But here we go. I'll let you guys take a look. The paper, boom, right there. Got that green regular paper, but there you go. You could see it right there. So this is the Nike Dunk SB Paisley. Like I said, StockX tags. It looks like they got some different ones. Darker green. Be on the lookout for this. It's just a little bit darker color green with the X in the back. But here you go. So these are the Paisleys. I want to say they came out this month. I want to say they came out overseas because I don't think they hit skate shops first or in the US yet. I'm sure they're probably making their way around the skate shops pretty soon. But actually, these are tearaway, so like, or cutaway. So I wouldn't say they're tearaway because you can't really hard to tear this stuff away. So you would have to use an X-Acto knife and go ahead and cut these up. But basically, underneath this paisley pattern is you got your, I'm not sure, some different type of material underneath and different colors underneath. So let me give you a little quick close-up. But like I said, I'll be doing sneaker profiles on these, so be on the lookout for that. Gum bottom, pink hit in the middle. Cool little touch, got those pink hits in the middle in the insole. But what do you guys think about these? Is this going to be one of those summer shoes? Like I said, I purchased these really to go with this jacket. So when I do wear this jacket, either during fall or if we get a cold front coming in California, I can definitely wear these together, but I mean, to me, perfect. This does have that kind of like an iridescent look to it with these patterns, this paisley pattern. But I think this is a really cool shoe. At the price that I purchased it, easy buy. Oh, really quick, I did not see this, but you do have like a different kind of pattern, not your typical fabric pattern, more this is like a leather pattern. It kind of has that like that elephant touch to it. So that's a pretty cool little touch. Didn't even recognize it until right now. So pretty cool of Nike SB to do that, especially on a GR. But let me know what you guys think about these pickups. Just a couple for this week. I do have more coming in. I do have more here. I just haven't, I'm not gonna spend a whole episode of just opening a bunch of stuff up. Just wanna open a little bit at a time to show you. I felt like these were, this one was especially important, and then also this one because they go together. And then basically I could create my short on these two things. So I appreciate you for coming in the building. Let me know what you think about these SBs. Let me know what you think about this jacket. Let me know what you think about John Elliott as a brand with his collaborations with LeBron. If you guys were able to pick up any of those, the shoes or the clothing, whatever have it, let me know. Like I said, I always size one size down when it comes to John Elliott stuff because it's just oversized. I'm not into that whole baggy look, or those, long tees. I try to keep it more fitted style for myself. But I do have some of that stuff in the collection or in my wardrobe. But I just kind of have to be careful on how that style, those type of items. I appreciate you for showing up. Thank you again. Thank you so much for coming in, for blessing the Sneaker Factory with your view. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Hopefully it's helpful, especially if it's if you're deciding to pick up this jacket or these pair of shoes. Like I said, be on the lookout for the profiles. I will be doing those pretty soon, and hopefully you guys will be tuning into those. But I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you so much, ladies. I appreciate you, fellas. I appreciate you also. Thank you for showing up, for blessing the channel. Hope to catch you pretty soon on another sneaker profiles. Hopefully you guys are tuning into all those shorts. And then also hopefully I'll catch you pretty soon on another Floyd's Pickups next week. Business as usual. But until then, you guys stay blessed. Have a blessed and safe day. And I will talk to you pretty soon.